In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the second technique, that is decision testing. Previously, we have seen condition testing, and now it's time for decision testing. So like previously, first we will try to understand what is the meaning of decision. And then we will see what is the meaning of decision testing and how to perform that. So let's start with the decision itself. So this is the same example which we have seen in the condition testing, where we have seen if A and B is nothing but a decision. And we have also seen that A and B as an individual entity are called atomic conditions. Now since we are talking about decision testing, so A and B are of no use to us. Whereas we have to focus on if A and B. So this whole is like a decision. So for this, as a whole, we have to complete true and false. So one time this complete decision has to become true, and next time this has to become false. And we are not caring about what is the value of A and B. What we care about is the whole decision has to become true and false. In order to understand it better, now let's see what is the meaning of decision testing. So going with the same example, if A and B, so we will have a same table here, where A and B are the conditions, and if A and B is a decision. So as I told you, now our focus is on the decision. We don't care what combination we will get here. What we are caring about is, we should get false once for the complete decision, and next time we should get a true. So this is what we want to achieve. And in order to achieve this scenario, we can have different combinations here. Let's see the two combinations which I have selected. So for A, first we will make it as a false. Then for B, we will make it as false. Then the whole decision will be false, because false and false will be false. Now let's see the second condition. For A I have covered true, and for B also I have covered true. So if both are true, true and true is true. So now we have achieved false and true. So 100% decision testing coverage we have achieved. Now let's see one more example here. I will select a different combination. So what I am selecting is, for A, I am selecting true. Okay. And for B, I am selecting false. Now A is true, B is false. So true and false will be false. But if I make this as false, but then you are not achieving 100% condition coverage, because this two statement will become true and true. For B, we are achieving 100% condition coverage, but for A, we are not achieving 100% condition coverage. And that's the reason we cannot say that having a 100% decision coverage will result in 100% condition coverage. It is not so. So that is the reason there is no statement here, like for condition coverage. 100% condition coverage will not make sure 100% decision coverage. Similarly, 100% decision coverage cannot make sure 100% condition coverage. So hope you have understood how we have to perform the decision testing and what we have to focus on. That is it from this particular slide, and I will see you with the next video. Until then, happy testing.